programs, but we promised to post them online. Turnout is amazing because we have so many different departments of the university and other universities in Arizona involved. We have funding from the Emeritus College, and representing the Emeritus College is Professor Verdini. Would you please stand up? And I'm pleased to say there are 11 other academic units that have contributed to make this series of events possible. We also have funding from University of Arizona and Northern Arizona University, and Mr. Arao will be performing there this week. For a full list of events,
the abroad program to teach Japanese language, religion, and culture. My husband's Japanese religion and culture course consisted of field trips every weekend. The first week was always Miyajima, where there is a shrine made into a gorgeous building by Taira Kiyomori, who strengthened the ties of his clan, the Heike, to the throne through his daughter's marriage into the imperial family, so that the Heike became the most powerful clan at the time. In the third year of our summer program, during the students' free time in Miyajima, I went up to Senjoka, 1,000 tatami mat hall without any walls that overlooks Seto Maikai, the inland sea. And there, a young man in hoi, clerical garments, was singing and playing the biwa. I listened to this young, mysterious guy. Alas, after listening to only a couple more pieces of his music, it was time to get back to my students. But I decided to buy his CD. I remember it was Nasuno Yoichi. Ever since, we have always made sure that our field trip included Mr. Arao's Heike group performance. I have been thinking of bringing Mr. Arao to Arizona for many years, and it's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Arao to you tonight. These opening lines are for us. The Jetta banner, temple bells, ring the passing of all things. Twined sour tree, white in full flower, declare the great man's certain fall. The arrogant do not long endure. They are like a dream one night in spring. The bold and brave perish. In the end, they are as dust before the wind.
Heike, Shouhiji, Gion Shoujo.
thank you for your kind introduction. Hello everyone. My name is Tsutomu Arao. I'm Heike Bio player, storyteller of the tale of Heike. Thank you all for coming today to this concert. Thank you very much for inviting me to tell the story of the Heike. The Heike-ku is a Japanese traditional culture. This culture is so older than another Japanese culture, no kabuki, kyogen, jori, etc. For 800 years, the blind monks have been telling this story. The Heike is the destiny of the Heike family, Heike clan family. The Heike says nothing is permanent. Life comes and goes. You never know what will happen next in your life. Impermanent is a fundamental concept in Buddhism of all things. The Heike consists of 200 stories. Tonight, I will write five stories. The first is Gion Shoja. Gion Shoja is the most famous art. Japanese elementary school students study and run by rote.
Oh,
3度までこそ立てられけ。 Yeah.
changing forces were gathered together in the seashore when a Heike boat appeared. On it, a beautiful young girl landed on the hall, a bright red fan wearing a sun disc, apparently as a pilot. Sensing that this was meant to draw Yoshitsune, the Genji commander, closer to the shore, where he could be shot by an archer. The call went out for someone to shoot the fan. Masuno Yoichi, a young archer who could shoot birds in flight, was brought forth. The fan was far away, threatening in a strong wind from the boat that was tossing in high waves. The Heike gathered in their boats at sea as did the Genji on their horses on the shore. Yoichi swore that if he missed, he would die, and prayed to the gods for success. His arrow sunk in the air and struck the fan just above the pin. The fan flew into the sea. Its red and gold shining in the sunset's rays. The Heike pounded on the sides of their boats in admiration, while the Genji beat on their quivers in delight.
So the next song is Masuno Yoichi. Masuno Yoichi is a person's name. He shot the fan over the Heike's ship on the sea. So the fan is this. So its distance from Masuno Yoichi to the Heike's ship is about 90 meters. So Yoichi completed a difficult mission. The Heike and the Genji clapped and cheered him. So next is Masuno Yoichi.
Heike Masuno Yoichi.
Okay, the next number is Nododo no Saigo, the death of Norizne. Actually, I requested him to play Minigashi Hoichi might have played, and this is one of them, so I'm really, really looking forward to hearing this. In the climactic sea battle of Danora, Norizne, having no more arrows, knew this day was his last. So with weapons in each hand, leaped from boat to boat with fierce cries, hoping to kill the Genji commander Yoshitsune. When he landed on Yoshitsune's boat, Yoshitsune sprang 20 feet onto a boat filled with his soldiers. Unable to match that feat, Norizne threw his ribbons and armor aside, loosened his hair, spread his arms, and shouted for anyone who wants to take him alive to come and try. Three men from the Genji side, one with the strength of 30 men together with a retainer and younger brother just as strong, took a small boat up to Norizne's and jumped aboard. Norizne kicked the retainer into the sea with thunderous splash and cramped the other two under each arm, saying, "Fine, you're coming with me, you two lads, on the road to death." He plunged with them into the wave.
Next is Nododo no Saigo. Nododo no Saigo is a story of a fierce battle, the Danora. Nododo no is the official postman. His name is Norizne Taira. He expected heavy fighting. Finally, he held two enemies under his arms. He met a heroic death in this battle. So, Nododo no Saigo.
Heike Yeah.
Sente Bodhis. Now Sente Bodhis is explanation.
The last number is Sente Bodhis, the drowning of Emperor Ambo. Late in the Battle of Damodara, the Genji were pulling on to the Heike boats. The Empress Lady Ni clutched her six-year-old grandson, the Emperor Antoku, in her arms, together with some imperial regalia, when he asked where she was taking him. She said that this land, which is his parent, is no longer a nice place, and that he should say farewell to the Issei Shrine in the east and pray to Amida Buddha in the west, and that underneath the sea, another capital awaited him. They then plunged into the depths. Alas, the spring winds of transience, in one brief instant, swept away the beauty of his lovely blossom, a Brahma in his lofty palace, an Indra in his stern citadel, whose word had once been law. Two ministers and senior nobles first sought refuge aboard a ship, then met his end beneath the wave. A sadder tale as any ever told.
So, Sente Gojusui is the most famous story of the final battle of Danora. The Emperor Antoku was 8 years old. His grandmother took him and plunged with him into the sea. This tale is the most saddest and noble in the tale of the Heike.
Heike, Sente Gojusui. Yo mo
Tai なんですけど、これからあの question and answer. So if you have any questions, there's a wireless microphone on each end. So please come forward and.After this, after the question and answer session, Mr. Arao will come down to the floor, and he would like to, for you to watch, to see his diva closely, and you can touch too, I think. No question? Shall we just do touching? question? Hi.
Hello. how long did it take to practice and strengthen your voice to perform?
3 years practice.
First, only voice, training voice. 1 year after, so first time play the viola.
She said, she said, how long does it take to sing that well? And he said 3 years.And, それから何でしたっけ
Started with voice.
Oh, はい。そう、聞こえました。Started to voice. So, did I say okay?
Yeah,
and then play the piano.
This is hard to formulate as a question, but Homer's Odyssey and the Iliad were actually written down a long time after him, and they were part of an oral tradition of poetry. And I'm wondering if there's such a kind of tradition, there must be in Japan, an oral tradition. I mean, this text, I think it was 800 years old, but were there people who were memorizing and singing the whole thing? And I mean, is it similar to that? I mean, it's 800 years ago, it's not 3,000 years ago. If I have Homer right, it's like 2,500 years. But is this an oral tradition as well? When was the text written? And were people singing? I mean, this is a historical event 800 years ago.I didn't formulate that question at all.
We don't know for sure. Supposed to, well, it was an oral first, and then, yeah. And then.
Prior year, 50 or 60 times I played a beer on weekend.
But not the weekend, so I take holiday of company. I have one daughter and one son, so I must pray with them and work and the prayer viewer. So, but I like the prayer viewer, so I continue to pray the viewer with work and harmony.
Thank you.
It's very difficult to take long vacation, and so this time he was awarded a vacation for his 15 years of work. So he came here.
Is the Japanese language that you sang today very different than modern spoken Japanese?
Yes, this Japanese is old Japanese. Old Japanese song.
Is it very difficult for modern Japanese people to understand?
Yeah, very different from modern Japanese. Modern Japanese listen this song. They don't recognize the half of this.
But I think you can take headband senses course.
Do you play any other instruments other than piano?
I was wondering if you know possibly how many man hours go into making such a biwa, and possibly like the cost of actually having one.
You want the how much this one costs?
how much it costs and how many hours it takes, or days or months, to make a biwa. Takes 10 years.
You had mentioned Miyajima. I was wondering if you had
vocation that you performed consistently in Japan? So you don't have one particular place that you perform consistently in, you just tour? The booklet that you're reading out of, does that also include music notation as well, so you know what pitch to sing, or is that memorized?
Yes, I almost memorized. But